Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Legend of Majora's Mask. And last time we started the game and got the magic bar. Today we are going to do some more stuff with Equilink here. So you can come here and shoot this balloon. And this guy freaks out. That's a tough one. And so we have to go to get a place here. You get to an observatory, and these guys will get there. You have to catch. You're playing a little hide and seek game. You gotta catch them all. But yeah, we gotta catch them all. There's one over here. There's one this way. Behind the slide. There's one there. We got the leader. Okay, we got three. Find two over here. Two over here on this side, which is I believe the east or the top down. East block down a bit. The one over here is actually really annoying. Not this guy, I'm okay with this guy. Because one thing you can do is use the bubble and stun him. Okay, but you got him. This guy isn't as annoying as another guy is, but he's still struggle. I'll give him a nod. So this guy here, this guy always gave me so much trouble when I ever did this. Because if he starts running, he can run behind the guard. And since your deck is struck, the guard will pull you past. Or not let you outside of bounds, you can't pass it. This is one of the most annoying things ever, but we got it first try, thank god. You can also run you into loading zones in different areas. Okay, so now we got to find the last guy. And it is over here. Not on this side, but on this side, block down. And he's right over there. And he's in west block down. So yeah, let's run up here. Get this guy. Boom, got them all. But now they're gonna teach us the code. There's 3-4-2-5-1. Let's go. We're gonna get into a match with the key at the east side. We're gonna get us down in the little alleyway. Gonna talk to this guy. So I believe it was 3-4-1-5-2. Okay, I'm out of. Okay, so if you forget the code, don't worry about it. These guys can if you find one of the bombers running around somewhere, it'll tell you the code again. I kinda forgot it. 4-2-5-1. 2-5-1. Okay, I swapped that 2-1. That's what they're drawing. 3-4-2-5-1. 3-4-2-5-1. Boom, okay, got that time. I kinda forgot the code there. So now we gotta go down in here. So I won't be talking much about this beginning part will not be. I mean, maybe throughout this whole thing. I won't be. Majority of my commentary will not be guiding you through the game, but I will be feeling it quite a bit. So I do want to talk about some personal stuff. Not personal stuff, but stuff that's been going on in the community. What happened? Was it flooding or something? So, let's just go along up here. Now we're in the observatory. Like, cool, let's go like this place. this is the place where you can pull off the infamous corpse day glitch. So you ask the telescope and you hit yes, you can look around the entire place, the entirety of the field with the wind outside the terminal. So you see these guys here? These are the stealth that are marking their time. And although these guys will never appear when you're outside, what they will instead, they'll be secrets. These guys will appear secrets around the map. Around the field. So what we gotta do actually is go over here and zoom in. You can see the skull kid looking up at the moon. And things come from it. Okay, so now we have to just go on here. And let's go with it. And we gotta have to go to those here. Now we gotta go all the way back to South Lockdown. So there's a lot of cool games that have been announced and released as well. I've been watching the shows, or seasons of shows. I think they decided to put a sequel to Breath of the Wild. I think that game is going to be awesome. And the bell ring and the night time. But the sequel to Breath of the Wild looks amazing. The DLC stuff for Smash Bros. Ultimate is amazing. I have the Sans costume. I always borrow that high train. Yeah, what's going on top of the screen there? That's gonna get annoying. I gotta try and fix that. So now we gotta put the moon here, and we gotta go over here. Play with this flower, this guy will stop you. And this is how I give the moon steal this guy. I really hope this Breath of the Wild sequel. It looks amazing, but I hope we have a sense that Breath of the Wild didn't have. Like the hookshot. I would like to see the hookshot. What else would I like to see? I would like to see a Dark Link fight. Dark Link is my favorite mini boss ever. What is the enemy? He's been one of my favorites for a long time, since I first encountered him in Ocarina of Time. And every time I play a game with Dark Link, that's like one of the things I'm most excited for whenever I get to where Dark Link is. And then we have access to this flower, and we can shoot up, just going on to way up high, and fly over this and collect the harpies. So now this thing won't open until the final day, the final day. So we basically just have to sit here and do nothing. But we're not gonna do that. Actually, you know what? I'll go for a while. I'm gonna go collect some rupees. So if you go over to this side, there's a place you can get rupees from. We're gonna just head here. So this guy back here, we can't think about him now, but he's gonna have a really nice side quest coming up after we get back into our human form. His name is Khan. We can't do anything about him yet though. Thank you. Looks like we hold on nothing to do in here in deck form. You know what? I might just end this here and go do stuff on off screen when I'm not recording, like go throw my wallet and take stuff back to the final day. So actually, yeah, so I'm gonna do. So yeah, thank you for watching. If someone's watching this, thank you for watching. I'll see you guys in the next episode. Goodbye.